For me, the marathon was like taking your life and all your internal thoughts that encompass it. You know, all that internal stuff that normally no one sees or hears about, and project it outward, bare and naked. Your true self, if you will, for hours on end. It's about your outlook on life, your attitudes, your self-talk, and it's all outside of you, for what feels like the first time, for the world to see. It's a surreal experience, as not only are you bare, but so are hundreds of others around you. And people can see it all, for when physically strained, you can't or choose not to cover up your true thoughts, decisions, outlooks, and self-talk. It all shows. All of the runners, we were exposed in going through this journey separately and together all at the same time. And like any great mythological journey, there's a vast cast of characters. Characters of all shapes and sizes. So the stage and cast is set. The learning journey has begun with trials, tribulations, and choices. Lots and lots of choices. Not only do you learn about yourself, as this is a self-discovery journey, but since we are all bare, you learn about others, humankind, and its vast cast of characters. You overhear personal struggles. You see personal struggles. You see personal successes. It's as if each separate character animates every attitude, thought, and expression that exists in the world, and is exemplifying it for you to learn, like getting a sneak peek preview of life, instead of having to look back at it all once you have passed away. And this great life show is compressed down for you to witness in just a few hours. Life fast forward and all-encompassing, if you will. I was just in a happy state of mind. Well-being is the best word for it, even when things got hard. And they did get hard. I, like all the other characters, was not immune to the trials, tribulations, and choices. It was roughly mile 20, and we hadn't come up to a decent hill in quite a while. We turned a corner, and there it was, a hill. I realized I needed to do something, and pretty quickly. It seemed like mentally I was about to go downhill. I looked at the hill and thought, I can't let a single negative thought creep into my mind. I'm going to make this positive. So I said out loud, I love hills. And that was the beginning of the mantra. For each step, I would say one word of, I love hills, to myself most of the time. Before I knew it, I was halfway down the other side of the hill and wasn't even breathing any harder than normal. I'd finished the hill and didn't even know it. Huh, that worked pretty well. And I realized, I do love hills. You get to go down them too. Hills are a positive thing. They're a change from the norm. Attitude, thought, and self-talk is everything. At mile 25 and still loving hills, I passed a lady walking. Now, there's nothing wrong with walking. We all walk, just about, during these long distance races. In fact, my mantra for my first marathon was run, walk, crawl, or drag myself by my eyelashes. I will finish. Anyhow, I heard her footsteps pick up in tempo as soon as I passed her and realized that she had started running again. We then turned a corner, and what did we see? You guessed it, a hill at mile 25. And we both had the exact same word thought at the exact same time. She vocalized hers. It was, oh, groan. A hill. And she stopped running instantly. She was doing great, but her brain made her stop. We haven't even started to go up the hill yet. I had the exact same thought, oh, a hill. And I love hills. At that point, performance was completely dependent upon attitude, and it was wonderful. Finishing was overwhelming. I couldn't believe I was there, even though I knew I would be there. I smiled as I crossed the mats, heard the beep of my timing chip, and finally crossed under the arch of balloons. I hugged my family, who was there waiting, and then started to cry happy tears. I did it. For those curious about time and results, I'm not a fast runner. I finished 2/3 of the way back in the pack. It's not about time or placement. Like life, it's about the journey. What did you learn about yourself? What did you learn about others? What did you learn about life? Did anyone surprise you? Did you surprise yourself? I am a runner. I love running. I am a finisher. I love being a runner and a finisher.